It's billed as the Battle of Cameron. West Covina High School and South Hills. West Covina comes in 1-1. South Hills is 1-0 after a defeat of Baldwin Park High School. It's Thursday night, and we're coming to you live from Covina District Field. Their offense coming in against you guys?
Their offense has played well the whole year except for one little short time in their first game. And they're doing a very good job getting the ball spread around to different guys who are very talented. You come in against an offense like that on a short week, and we got a very young defense. I mean, that offense would have given us trouble anyways, but it's a little bit harder. It's a little bit harder, and it showed. We misaligned a lot. Some of our guys were just their second game ever playing varsity football, and they took advantage of it as they should, and they did, and it hurt. But, you know, we'll get better. The team didn't quit. We've done some very good things offensively out there today, and we'll be back. It's a very good football team. My hat goes off to them. Huh? They make you better.
Good to have, like you just said, you got the Cerro next week, then Monrovia, then Los Osos, then you get into league.
These guys know that this is a challenge, all right? This is a challenge, the schedule and the league and everything is a challenge. In life, you're going to have lots of challenges, and sometimes athletics can be a sort of a microcosm to help you prepare for that. And they're going to show up every stinking week, and that's all they're called to do. Winning is really, you know, giving everything you got, become the best you can be. You can't control those other factors. We talk like we can, but we can't. So if we show up every week, prepare hard, play hard, that's all we're asking for.
Big win for West Covina tonight, 42-27. Let's hear from Coach Mike Majora.
Talk about your offensive line against your big defensive line.
Kind of what I was hoping for. We have a lot of confidence in them. They're strong. They've worked hard. I think we have two of the better. I know everyone's talked about their offensive line, but we feel like we have a pretty good offensive line, too. And we have a couple other guys that can fill in. Our back, Solomon, had good points today, so he didn't play much. And our other two guys ran hard.
You guys just kept pounding it and pounding it and pounding it. Was that the game plan tonight?
Well, we like to do that. We like to mix it up a little bit. But when the run is working, it's hard not to keep running the ball. And it was working tonight. And the kids did a great job of coming off the ball hard and playing with confidence.
Coach, talk about that confidence. I think 42 points is the most points anyone's put on South Hills this decade. I mean, how far have you come in 2 weeks?
We played four quarters again, the Covina game, we just made a lot of mistakes, and I knew that wasn't the real team that we were going to be, but it was good for us. It put us back on track and helped us focus a little bit. And it was last week we played a good Vantage team that was that had trouble stopping our offense and especially the run, and then this week was the same way. And we're going to need to throw the ball during the course of the season, but you know, running the ball is what we've done for years. And
How difficult is this team to defend? I mean, one week it's Chris Solomon, the next week it's B.J. Lee. I mean, you talked about having this handful of backs. That's got to be tough when you're watching film to prepare for you guys.
Yeah, we have a lot of guys we have confidence in. And what it comes down to is the offensive line. When they open holes, you know, we have the guys that can get through the holes. And we have more than one. So it is nice to, you know, keep guys fresh. And they're all, you know, chomping at the bit to get the ball. So it's a good thing. You want your backs to be hungry and want the ball. And running behind our offensive line is a pretty nice thing to do, I think.
Thanks, Coach.
We're here with B.J. Lee from West Covina High School. He had a big night tonight. B.J., talk about what your O-line did for you.
My O-line had good protection tonight, great protection. They didn't give up the whole way. They fought as if they were better than South Hills all night long. They showed it, the hard work at practice, the hard work in the weight room, everything, all the perseverance that we put in for all summer, all 9 months this year, they showed it tonight. The O-line put in way more work than the rest of the team did.
How did you feel your eyes light up when you saw the open field, especially on the last touch?
I mean, I see it and I just play off instinct. I don't try to think about it. I just see the hole and I go and I trust my speed over everything. and I just use my instinct to get around everybody.
Can you talk about the confidence of this team now? I mean, you lose to Covina. I know you guys are all down. You come back and beat Venice and South Hills in back-to-back weeks.
At practice, the coaches worked this. It was pain, but we got more hungry and more hungry all practice, all week long. All we did was work. It was hell again, but, I mean, we came back. We beat Venice, and then the confidence built from there, and then we figured that, you know, it's a rivalry between South Hills and us. We have to come back hungrier than we did against Venice, so we got to show everybody that we can fight and that we're ready to win.
Lindora next week.
Lindora next week, man. We're ready to go. We got to go to practice this week, work hard, and get ready for them on Friday night.
Thank
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Final score tonight, 42-27. West Covina goes to 2-1 next week. They got a tough game at Glendora. South Hills has a tough game themselves. They're at Tesoro. They fall to 1-1. So the battle of Cameron is over. West Covina is your champion tonight. I'm Tom Kiss for the Tribune Sports.